I think we can all agree that 2020 didn't exactly go the way we thought it would.
We now have a name for the disease, and it is COVID-19.
For most of us, teenagers especially, quarantine sucked. It amplified issues already present even before COVID, and presented us with a concept that, as a society, we'd never experienced before. A mandatory, unending supply of free time. In this video, I want to tell you the story of how I wasted a year and a half of my life playing Minecraft, and how the experience laid the foundation for a strong video game addiction, one that I could have carried with me for the rest of my life had I not stopped when I did. Minecraft is the best-selling video game of all time. For most people, the Minecraft experience involves building stuff and surviving in a sandbox, single-player environment. The concept is wholesome, runs on virtually every modern computer, and appeals to a huge age demographic, all of which contribute to its success. Right before quarantine began, a friend at school introduced me to multiplayer Minecraft, a mode where you can play online with other people on privately hosted servers. Specifically, he introduced me to a server called Hypixel that runs a minigame called Bedwars. The concept of Bedwars is relatively simple. You are placed in a ring of floating islands surrounding an even bigger island called Mid. Each team has their own island with a bed on it, which they try to defend by covering it with different blocks. At the back of the base, there's a generator, which spawns iron and gold, which are used to buy things from the shopkeeper. You win the game by bridging to other people's islands, breaking their bed, and killing them. The mid-island has a generator that spits out emeralds, which you can use to buy better swords, stronger armor, etc. The last team, or player alive, wins. I started playing Bedwars regularly and began getting frustrated at how easily everyone could beat me. My lack of skill primarily came down to my lack of experience with video games as a whole, considering the only game I've ever owned is Minecraft. Up until then, I had only ever used it in single player, where I could play at my own pace without a need for anything more than a basic understanding of the game. As I continued to get frustrated at myself for being so bad, while it seemed everyone else was naturally good, I started playing more and more, watching tutorial videos, and overall absorbing myself in the game as much as possible. I began making friends I found through the game, and we'd talk and play Bedwars for hours over Discord. This cycle continued on and on, and with it, my passion for anything else drifted away. I didn't care about developing myself as a person, just improving my kill-death ratio. With endless time and the satisfaction of improving virtual numbers, nothing else mattered. At the same time, I was also pouring my savings into the game, buying endless cosmetics for myself and my online friends. While I didn't realize it at the time, many of these people weren't actually my friends, just other teenagers who hid behind their anonymous usernames, happy to block me at a moment's notice with seemingly zero remorse. And yet, I continued playing, continued ignoring the obvious signs that my health was degrading, became more and more toxic, and spent more and more money, fueled by the bad influences ever present around me. I was frustrated at myself and others when things didn't go as planned. At the level I was hoping to achieve, even the smallest slip-up in-game could alter my stats and ruin an entire day of effort. My mood and view of myself were determined by making zero mistakes over the period of a 10-hour day, something that the human body was not made for. Pale, gaunt, and depressed, I looked at my reflection in my monitor at the end of these grinding sessions to see nothing that I stood for previously. It might sound dramatic, but it was the reality I wasn't willing to face. Then, on July 29th, 2021, just as quickly as it started, I was snapped back to reality in the form of a solo vacation, and I haven't played competitively since. So, to everyone who asked what I did during quarantine, hopefully this video serves as an explanation. And now I can go back to watching my fellow 18-year-olds head off to college, tackle jobs and internships, while I rediscover my former passions and go back to do the things I should have done when I was 16. As the people I used to play with would say, I touched grass. Secondary is not in my vocabulary. Communicating my ideals like a missionary. The life that I'm living is far from the ordinary. Cause I'll be running after the cheddar like it's Tom and Jerry. Ooh, walk around the city in every direction. Yeah, red and green lights shining in.